Hi, my name's Everett Minshall, and today's video is about how I approach studying concepts that I'm either not very familiar with, not very interested in, or I need to just learn it, but I'm having a hard time learning enough material that will help me progress on to the next stage of the course that I'm taking. You may have come across other videos that I've made talking about my experience at WGU. Some people have asked for me to make a video about how I approach studying specifically, so I thought I'd just make a video about that. I haven't really planned this out, so if I start to ramble on, I apologize, but I'm just sort of going off the top of my head here. So in WGU, it may have changed. I think the last course I did was April 2022, and there were two types of sort of ways that you'd be evaluated on a particular class. One way was that you would just write an essay, or the other way would be that you take a proctored exam. And my approach to I wanted to get done with WGU as fast as I could, so I would just take the practice exam. And if I passed that practice exam, I'd go straight into the final exam and I'd skip all of the material and just get that class over with and move on to something else. But occasionally I would run into a course where I had to go back through the material and learn new concepts and familiarize myself with the knowledge material that WGU was giving me so that I could pass the test, the proctored test, basically. I should mention here that as far as essays go, it doesn't really matter, because with essays, what's nice about WGU is you can just turn in the most like first draft, you know, just BS your way through that first draft. Submit it, and WGU will just continue to offer rewrites and just tell you exactly what parts of your essay that you need to change. And so what I found was I didn't ever need to look at the material. I could just write just garbage first draft essays. They would evaluate it and tell me exactly what I need to change. I would just do what they tell me to do as best as I could and resubmit it. And 9 times out of 10, I just passed. They accepted the second draft, basically. So everything I'm going to say is about those instances where I took the practice test and failed, or I didn't pass, or I needed to learn a few other subjects within that course. I would take the practice exam. If there were like areas that I didn't do well on, and that's what caused me to not pass the practice exam, I would go straight to those areas and I would study those areas. And then I would retake the practice exam. And once I passed it, I'd take the test, the final test. And so in WGU, it may have changed now depending on when you're watching this, but when I was taking it, the practice exam will tell you exactly what areas of the course that you need to study. And it's actually really great because it tells you exactly, yeah, what areas of the course or of the class that you're not performing well at, and like where you're not competent, where you're approaching competence, and where you're like really struggling. You can just go to those like unit sections, basically. And you can just study those specific areas. So in a class, you might be competent in 2 out of 4 of the topics that you need to be competent in. And then instead of studying the whole course material, you can just focus on those 2 areas that you really need to focus on. For example, if I would take a course, I was a business major, so if I took a course on like accounting and I struggled on a couple parts where I needed to learn about certain concepts, I would just go to those concepts and learn about it. And the way I would learn about it is each chapter of each unit in the class, right? So if you think about it hierarchically, you have the class that you're taking, you have the individual units that make up that class, and then you have like chapter tests, basically. So you could, if you take a practice exam and it tells you you need to focus on chapters, you know, X and Y, you can go straight to those chapters and just study those chapters. The WGU does actually a really good job about telling you exactly what you need to learn and what you need to work on. And basically the only thing that I would work on is I would read through it once, and then I would take like the chapter summary tests as like a way to practice, because a lot of the times those chapter summary tests are going to look extremely similar to your final test questions or your chapter test questions. Really, it's less about understanding specific questions and more about like understanding the concepts and understanding how those concepts are going to be asked. Once you take a couple of tests, you'll understand what I'm saying here. Basically, like, you'll take a test and sometimes you'll come across a question where you're like, okay, it could be asking for this answer or this answer. And unless you practice these questions over and over again, you don't really know what it's looking for. So in those instances, those chapter tests are really helpful, because you'll know exactly, like, and because the chapter tests tell you what questions you get right and wrong. So you'll know exactly, like, okay, I understand what this question's asking now, and I know what answer it's looking for. And so you'll come across similar questions like that in your final exam, and it'll be a lot easier. I feel like my advice isn't very good if you really want to learn the concepts and the material. I was just trying to get through WGU as fast as I possibly could, because I was looking toward other things and I had other things going on in my life that I wanted to just get to. And I knew I needed a undergraduate degree to get there. I learned through doing, and when it comes to WGU, the thing you need to do to accomplish your undergraduate degree is pass the tests and write essays. So if you get really comfortable, like, test taking skills is going to like really help you, and like not freaking out on a question that you don't know, but really just thinking logically and like coming up with techniques on how to best take the test, you're probably going to go through the course a lot faster than you would if you just, you know, really relied on knowing the material. And whether that's fair or not is up for debate, but it certainly works out for those types of people that want to get through WGU as fast as they can. Now, it just came to me, there's a third test that WGU employs, and this is for you computer science IT people out there. I took a business degree, but even in the business degree, there were a lot of courses that were tested around how well I knew Microsoft Excel. And there were certainly things in those classes where there'd be no way I could pass the test unless I went through the entire course material to learn it. Because if you have to memorize specific functions within a software program, you're going to have to know exactly how to do that. There's going to be no multiple choice on that. It's going to ask you, like, do this task in the software that you're learning. In my case, as a business person, it was only Microsoft Excel, but I imagine if you're like learning AWS, or if you're learning, you know, other IT software concepts, you're probably going to have to like actually use the software to pass your test. So in those instances, like there's nothing you can do. Just go through the course material and like really practice the practice exams and the practice questions, because that's the only way you're going to really retain that knowledge for the test. I hope that helps. I think I rambled a lot in this video, but that's basically the way I approached studying courses that I wasn't very well versed in or that I needed to study in. And hopefully it gives you some insight into how WGU structures its course material and test material. Like I said, I graduated in May of 2022, somewhere in there. So things may have changed depending on when you're watching this video. I hope this helps. If you enjoy it, let me know in the comments and check out some of my other videos. I'm just going along this education streak, getting a certificate in data science. And after this, once I get some work, I think I'm going to go for my master's in statistics. So I really hope this channel will be like a way to show people how you can go from like an undergraduate with a non-traditional background all the way to a graduate degree, doing something very technical with a business background as well. So yeah, be sure to subscribe if that's something that you think you'd be interested in. And yeah, be sure to learn, apply, and thrive. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.